if there is a difference between our life and the fulfillment and the enjoyment of God's promises, it's our fault.
Help us, Lord. Help us, Lord.
If we find ourselves lacking, it is because of our unbelief in the love of God, in the power of God, and in the reality of God's promises. It was unbelief that caused the Israelites their troubles.
Right.
It wasn't because God was holding back on his promises.
That's right. That's right.
It was their unbelief.
That's right.
Psalm 78, 15 through 19. Listen to what it says. It says, he clave the rocks in the wilderness, and he gave them drink as out of the great depths. He brought streams also out of the rock, and he caused waters to run down like rivers. And they sinned yet more against him by provoking the Most High in the wilderness. They provoked him, and they tempted God in their heart by asking meat for their lusts. Yea, they spake against God. They said, can God furnish a table in the wilderness after he did everything that he already had done?
Lord Jesus.
Move down to that 41st verse. Yea, they turned back and they tempted God.
Jesus.
And then it's put what follows and limited the Holy One of Israel.
Yeah.
They tied God's hand behind his back.
Yeah.
Amen. I need to
bless him.
Finish next week. Amen.
Bless him. Bless him.
Thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Holy Ghost.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Because when the children of God got to Kadesh Barnea, and God told them to enter the land flowing with milk and honey, where there would be rest, abundance, and victory. Only two men said yes.
All right.
We can take possession. They believed God. For God can make us conquer. Hold on. But the 10 spies and the 600,000 men answered in this way. No, we can never take the land. The enemies are too strong. Our problems are too big. Our situations are too difficult. And it was their unbelief that kept them out of the promised land.
Yes, it was.
And it was their unbelief that kept them from, thank you, Lord Jesus, it kept them from experiencing their privilege. They were not ready to be blessed. You see, to be blessed, you gotta be ready to be blessed. And to be ready to be blessed, you gotta deal with your unbelief. You gotta handle your unbelief.
Yes.
You gotta face your unbelief.
Yes.
If you want to experience the privilege, glory to God.
Yes.